Testing controls for the rapid response Strep A test device. Humidity and temperature can affect results. Do not use after the expiration date printed on the back of the pouch. Do not use the test if the foil pouch is damaged. Bring the test to room temperature before use. Read the instructions carefully before you begin. Good laboratory practice recommends the use of control materials to ensure proper kit performance. For external quality control testing, place the desired number of extraction tubes in the tube stand. Add 4 drops of reagent 1 and 4 drops of reagent 2 to each extraction tube. Mix the solution gently by swirling the extraction tubes. Mix the controls by shaking the bottle vigorously. Add 1 drop of positive control to 1 extraction tube and 1 drop of negative control to another extraction tube. Remove the sterile swab from its packaging and immerse it into the extraction tube. Swirl the swab in the extraction tube to mix it. Repeat the procedure for the second extraction tube. Leave the swab in the extraction tube for 1 minute. After 1 minute, squeeze the swab firmly against the tube to expel as much liquid as possible. Discard the swab. Repeat the procedure for the second extraction tube. For cassettes, attach the nozzle onto the extraction tube. For strips, do not attach the nozzle onto the extraction tube. Remove the cassette from its sealed pouch. Place the test device on a non-absorbent, clean and level surface. Optionally, label the device. Add 3 drops of the extracted solution onto the sample region of the test device. Avoid trapping air bubbles in the specimen region and do not add any solution to the results region. After adding the solution onto the test device, start a 5-minute timer. 4 test strips. Remove the test strip from its sealed pouch, holding the colored end. Do not touch the white section of the strip. Dip the test strip into the sample solution, immersing the test strip. Do not dip the strip past the solid max line. Wait for 1 minute. After 1 minute, remove the test strip from the tube and place it on a non-absorbent, clean and flat surface. Start a 5-minute timer. Read the test results between 5 to 10 minutes. Do not read results earlier than 5 minutes or later than 10 minutes. Interpretation of results. Positive results. 2 colored bands appear on the membrane. 1 band appears in the control region C. And another band appears in the test region T. Note, the intensity of color in the test region T may vary depending on the concentration of analytes present in the specimen. Therefore, any shade of color in the test region should be considered positive. Note that this is a qualitative test only and cannot determine the concentration of analytes in the specimen. Insufficient specimen volume, incorrect operating procedure, or expired tests are the most likely reasons for control band failure. Negative results. Only 1 colored band appears in the control region C. No apparent colored band appears in the test region T. invalid results. The control band fails to appear. Results from any test which has not produced a control band at the specified read time must be discarded. Please review the procedure and repeat with the new test. If the problem persists, discontinue using the kit immediately and contact your local distributor. If controls do not yield expected results, do not use the test. Repeat the test or contact your distributor. After you have finished testing, dispose of all used test materials in the trash.